questions?
Yeah, it was a tough game, hard-fought game, a very physical game. And, you know, we did some really good things at times throughout. We just didn't quite put it together in sequence that we probably needed to. Obviously, some turnovers in the first half slowed us down a great deal. Better job in the second half, but their O-boards, obviously pretty critical there, made a big difference. It's interesting how the game is played. At times, we were very wise, shooting 46% is very good. Obviously, we didn't take as many shots, but we forced them into 30% shooting, which is also very good. Unfortunately, the three-point shooting was a little bit better than that. That cost us that shot contesting in the corners and some good lessons for us to learn. And obviously, very, very disappointing on seeing that with Mercedes and what she's given our program, and Amber, what she's given our program over her time. It's very hurtful.
Joanne, regarding the threes, getting corner shots is not unusual for teams in the 2-3 zone. When they were going for that, and number 55, Harrison, got hot, what were you sort of thinking? Were you seeding that shot to prevent them from going inside?
Oh, no.
Or were you hoping that you could actually just contest that shot better, even though you knew that it would be open at least for a moment?
Absolutely, contest those shots. You know, we do a lot of in-face corner contesting. It's really disappointing it was one person. You know, I mean, sometimes a team can be hot, you know. But, you know, she hits six, and the next person hits two, and nothing much happens. So I think the most disappointing thing was not so much the location, the fact that we didn't handle 55. I mean, 55 earned the right to get a lot of attention, whether she was in the corner or in transition, for that matter. And it's very disappointing to not get that done.
Can you say there are lessons to be learned? Obviously, it's getting pretty late in the season to be learning lessons. You've got to wait for your next game. What's the emphasis going to be in that week?
Well, I beg to differ with your thinking. Sports is about learning lessons and life lessons, and they can be pretty difficult sometimes. So if you're not learning, I don't know why you'd be playing. So we're going to learn all through this season, all through next season, and all through whatever we can. This is not professional basketball. This is collegiate basketball. And these kids have done a remarkable job of having to reinvent themselves over and over again as we've dealt with some difficult situations. So I'm very proud of them for that. And adversity, you know, strikes, most definitely, and it did again today, especially with number 55. But perhaps the hot shooter next time will get a little bit more attention, or perhaps we'll get a few more offensive rebounds. But you know, you play these games, and this is because we're trying to get better as a team and as people and take those lessons.
Coach, how did you try and balance the rotation, especially in the third quarter when it seemed like every single person was going down with an injury? I feel like in a series of about like 3 or 4 minutes, three different players went down with injuries. How do you try and balance that as a coach?
Well, you just it's part of it. You know, it's a battle. It's just a battle out there, and everyone's fighting. And you just try to move on and look for the next person to contribute. Fortunately, it seemed like everybody kind of came back, right? You know, Angela did something, you know, Crystal. Various things occurred at the time, but it was great to see people come back and fight, and it was also good to see people step up when others couldn't. So that's an important part of being a team. And again, I think we just got out of ourselves a little bit. Those turnovers really, you know, starting the game 10-0 was fantastic, but we just really didn't handle that well. You know, we didn't handle that. We didn't continue to attack in the same way, turn the ball over, got a little careless. And then, you know, then you go from there.
Joanne, did Faith get hurt when she took that nasty elbow to the head?
I haven't talked to her yet. I think she's okay. But she did take a nasty elbow to the head.
Because she didn't come back in the game, and she played quite well against Virginia Tech.
Yeah.
Was she held out of the rest of the game because you liked what other players were doing, or were you worried about her condition?
Combination. I mean, when someone gets hurt like that, you get a little concerned. First thing you think is concussion. So you back off a little bit mentally, and then others, like Crystal was doing a pretty good job defending Prim, for example, and some others. So that's unfortunate she didn't get more time, but I certainly hope she's okay.
And with your much experience playing on the team later, what you got to wait for the next game? What lessons are you going to be trying to teach to your teammates?
I think it's just
staying with what's working and not breaking out of what we're doing well. I think there were times myself and others kind of got outside of, you know, the scheme we were running or, you know, the play we were running. I think just sticking with that, no matter where, if we're up, down, whatever, just sticking with the game plan is important.
Amber, Georgia Tech was among the most physical teams I've seen in person this year. How much do you think that sort of rattled your teammates a little bit?
I don't think it rattled us. We played physical teams before. Rattled is definitely not the right word. I think we could have handled it better, especially on offensive boards, but I guess overboard is really the place where you can see what we did before.
Rebecca, though, we got another game to go, but we're getting close to the ACC. You guys need to get hot and make a run. How do you guys feel about putting all the pieces together, especially when the Aztecs, you know, it's in depth?
I think we just need to take this week and really focus on the important aspects we need to work on, turnovers especially. We really just need to value the ball more. We can't have games with 20 or more turnovers anymore. And the intangibles, like Amber was saying, O-board, boxing out, that really can make or break a game. And so definitely work on the intangibles.
You know, there were some flashes at times. How do you guys feel confidence-wise about getting on the roll?
We're fine. We know what it feels like when we play well together. It's just getting there and doing the intangibles together.
Becca, what can you take positively out of this game, especially in terms of your chemistry with that network?
I think we just got off to a good start. I'm confident Angela can knock down three. I think we play well with each other, but I think we'll just continue.